Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. So children, in our previous class we have learned that the divisibility by 2 and the divisibility by 3, right? Now we'll continue. Let's see divisibility by 4 and the divisibility by 5. So take out page number 34 in your maths readers. See the divisibility by 4. A number is divisible by 4 if the number formed by the last two digits of the number is divisible by 4. See, consider the number 324. We know that 100, 200, 300, 400 and all, these all are divisible by 4. How? As 25 fours a 100, right? If you multiply 25 by 4, 25 into 4 will get 100. So 100, 200, 300, 400, these all are divisible by 4. Then in 324, 300 is divisible by 4, right? In 324, first we'll see 300, and 300 is divisible by 4. So we have to check whether 24 is divisible by 4 or not, right? Now it is divisible by 4 as, let's say 24. 6 fours are 24, right? We'll get 24 as 6 fours are 24. So the number 324 is divisible by 4. Okay, by following these steps we can find that the number, whatever the given number is there, that is divisible by 4 or not. Okay, see here we have an example. Example 16. Which of these numbers are divisible by 4? Here we have to check which of these two is divisible by 4. See, the first number is 736. In 736, 700 is divisible by 4, right? We know that. Then we have to check 36 is divisible by 4 or not. Now, the number formed by the last two digits 36 is also divisible by 4. This 32 also is divisible by 4. So hence 336 is divisible by 4. We can say that this 736 is divisible by 4. Then see the next number, 970. In that, 900 is divisible by 4, we know. Then we have to check 70 is divisible by 4 or not. Let's see. 900 is divisible by 4, but 70 is not divisible by 4. Here we cannot divide 70 by 4. So it means that the number 970 is not divisible by 4. Okay, this about the divisibility by 4. Next, see the divisibility by 5. We know that any multiple of 5 always has its units digit either 5 or 0. In 5 divisibility by 5, the number which are present at once place the unit digits, either it is 5 or 0. It means the last digit is has 0 or 5, then we can say that the given number is divisible by 5. For example, 25, 100, 130, etc., which all are divisible by 5 because the last digit, this ones digit, unit digit has 5 and this has 0, right? So we have to check the ones digit, that is either it should be 0 or it should be 5. Then we can say that the given number is divisible by 5. See here we have an example. Which of these number are divisible by 5? Let's see here, the number is 3457. So in that, the ones digit is 7. It neither 0 nor 5, it is 7. So this number is not divisible by 4. See the next one, 275. Here the ones digit is 5. Then we can say that 275, it is divisible by 5, right? Likewise, this also, here on the ones place we have the digit 0. So it means this number also divisible by 5. Okay, a number is divisible by 5 if the unit digit of the number is either 5 or 0. Okay, I hope you understand the divisibility by 4 and the divisibility by 5. Thank you.